Good day mga kasay. Ngayon naman ay pag-uusapan natin ang ilang mga questions sa subject na abnormal psychology. So we'll be posting some questions and I would like you to answer them. Okay? So let's start with the first question. Number one, all of the following are listed as disorder in DSM-5 except A. Obsessive-compulsive disorder, B. neurotic disorder, C. anorexia nervosa, or D. Tourette's disorder. Siya nga pala, mabilis lang naming pabanggitin ang mga question so you can pause this para masagutan mo yung bawat tanong. And now we go to number 2. Which of the following is not a technique used by Freudian therapy? Is it A. analysis of resistance, B. dream interpretation, C. hypnotic suggestions, or D. analysis of transference? And now we go to number 3. The learned helplessness model put forth by Seligman is a model of which of the following? Is it A. schizophrenia, B. autism, C. depression, or D. OCD or obsessive compulsive disorder? Number 4. Delusion, flat affect, and catatonic behaviors are all symptoms of A. schizophrenia, B. bipolar disorder, C. dissociative disorder, D. schizoid personality disorder. And number 5. A predisposition towards developing a specific disorder is an or A. transference, B. attributional style, C. ethology, or D. diathesis. And now we go to number 6. Which of the following is not an anxiety disorder in DSM-5? Is it A. zoophobia, B. conversion disorder, C. panic disorder, or D. selective mutism? Number 7. Pedro hears voices that tell him to kill people. He is experiencing A. delusion, B. obsession, C. hallucination, or D. illusion. Number 8. I am the most important person in the world. This is a statement that might be heard from a person with A. schizoid personality disorder, B. antisocial personality disorder, C. histrionic personality disorder, or D. narcissistic personality disorder. Number 9. Arnold is unable to move his right arm. He has been to many doctors, but no one has been able to find any physiological reason. He is suffering from A. conversion disorder, B. hypochondriasis, C. SAD or seasonal affective disorder, or D. OCD or obsessive compulsive disorder. And last, number 10. Mario is aroused by the thought that he is a woman. He is diagnosed as having A. masochism, B. frotteurism, C. paraphilia, and letter D. fetishism. And now we go to answers and explanation. Tignan mo yung sagot mo sa bawat question. Let's start with number 1. The correct answer is neurotic disorder. Neurotic disorder is not listed in DSM-5 because the DSM-5 attempts to be theoretical. And since neurosis is a term that is actually based on psychoanalysis, kaya hindi siya kasama sa DSM-5. Unlike yung OCD, which is characterized by persistent thoughts of individuals recognized as irrational or obsession, and repetitive impulse or compulsion. Ganoon din yung anorexia nervosa. Nasa DSM-5 din siya as a serious eating disorder characterized by refusal to maintain minimal normal body weight. At ganoon din yung Tourette's disorder characterized by multiple motor tics and one or more vocal tics. Let's now go to number 2. Ang tamang sagot sa number 2 is hypnotic suggestion. Marahil ay nagtataka kayo bakit hypnotic suggestion. Eh, si Freud ito. Hypnotic suggestion is not used in Freudian therapy, although Freud used it originally, no, but he quickly stopped dahil nakita niya na hindi effective ang paggamit nito. So, ang ginagamit niya is, meron tayong tatawag na resistance, which refers to the patient's unwillingness or inability to mention certain thoughts, motives, or experience to the therapist. By analyzing patient's resistance, the therapist can help break through the resistance and uncover the repressed materials. Ganun din yung pre-association, fundamental technique yan in psychoanalysis, where the patient says, whatever comes to mind, and no matter how painful or personal or irrelevant it may be. And of course, yung dream analysis is also used in psychotherapy to uncover the latent content of dreams and to understand the unconscious. And transference, of course, when the patient applies attitudes and feelings towards significant others to the therapist. And the number three answer is depression. Learned helplessness is a model of depression, which describes a situation in which the individual gives up because he sees no connection between his behavior and the desired reinforcement. Next, number four. Ang tamang sagot ay schizophrenia. Yan, delusion, plot affect, and catatonic behaviors are all symptoms of schizophrenia. Ano bang differences nito mga to? Pag sinabi natin delusion, these are false belief. Yung akala mo hinahabol ka ng maraming tao or akala mo ay gusto kang patayin ng ibang mga tao. Although, wala naman itong evidence. Okay? Yung flat affect naman, it refers to case where the patient shows almost no sign of emotional expression. And catatonic refers to movement disorder that can range from extreme rigidity to useless and bizarre movement not caused by any external stimulus. No? Unlike yung bipolar, which is characterized by extreme mood swing, dissociative disorder, characterized by avoidance of stress by escaping from personality identity, and the schizoid personality disorder is pervasive pattern of detachment from social relationship and restricted range of emotional expression. Number five, the answer there is diathesis. Yun yung tinasawag natin na predisposition towards developing a specific mental disorder. So if you still remember, yung diathesis stress model argues that mental illness results from interaction between a predisposition to a particular disorder and excessive stress. Meaning, merong mga tao na predisposed or prone na magkaroon ng ganitong disorder at natitrigger lang ng external factors. And then number six, the correct answer is conversion disorder. Conversion disorder is a type of somatic disorder na ngayon ay tinatawag na rin nating functional neurological symptom disorder, in which psychological problem manifests itself in one, often serious symptoms such as blindness and paralysis. And number seven, the correct answer is hallucination. Perceiving information when none exists, it is defined as hallucination. Again, ang delusion ay false belief, ang hallucination ay distorted perception, ang obsession ay persistent unwanted thoughts, ang illusion ay false perception. So, hindi proper na sabihin, o ikaw, nag-iillusion ka na naman sa idol mo, hindi magiging kayo. Ang proper ay nagdi-delusion ka na naman. False belief. Number eight, the correct answer is narcissistic personality disorder. Narcissism means love of oneself. People who view themselves as the focus of the world would most likely be classified as persons with narcissistic personality disorder. Yung antisocial that is characterized by pattern of disregard and violation of the rights of others. While yung schizoid naman, ito yung mga lumalayo sa mga tao, there is a pattern of detachment from social relationship and restricted emotional expression. And the essential feature naman of histrionic personality disorder is pervasive and excessive emotionality and attention seeking. And number nine, it's conversion disorder again. Many clinicians use the term functional, no, dun sa FNSD. Functional, referring to the abnormal central nervous system functioning. Or psychogenic, meaning yung assumed etiology niya is psychological, to describe the symptom of conversion disorder or yung tinatawag natin ngayon na functional neurological symptom disorder. So, pag bigla na lang sinabulag, wala namang problema yung kanyang mata, tinatakpan niya psychologically, tinatakpan ng psychological causes yung mga bagay na dapat ay nakikita niya. And yung hypochondriasis, ito yung laging nagpapacheck up sa mga doktor at ipinagpipilitan niyang meron siyang problema o meron siyang sakit kahit wala namang evidence physiologically. And then yung seasonal affective disorder naman, people become depressed during a prolonged period of bad weather. So lalo na kapag ka ikaw ay nakatira sa bansa na merong apat na season ng pagka-winter, marami talaga yung taong nade-depress. And number 10, it's paraphilia. Paraphilia involves sexual arousal and interest in people, object, or situation not generally considered arousing. Imagine, yung thought lang, arousing na para sa kanila. Although, yung arousal really starts with the thought, no? Pero ito ay iba. Pero unlike yung proturistic disorder, ang proturistic, ito naman yung they rub themselves sa strangers and they gain sexual satisfaction with it. At iba din naman yung sexual masochism because they enjoy being hurt, beaten, humiliated by other, and they gain sexual arousal doing so. Okay? And that's it. So thank you for tuning in dito sa video na to. And there will be more videos to come. Don't forget to subscribe. And share mo na rin sa iba pa nating mga kasayp para magkaroon pa tayo ng idea tungkol dito sa abnormal psychology. And I hope to see you again. Good day!